The internet and communications technologies have enabled unprecedented access to information with enormous social and economic benefits. Governments are responsible for national security and for protecting human rights. But as governments confront terrorism, hate speech, and misinformation online, some governments are pressuring companies to undermine technology users' freedom of expression and privacy rights. How can governments respond to legitimate concerns for public safety without turning to tactics like censorship, shutting down networks, and opaque and unaccountable surveillance? Recognizing the risks of such government pressures, 10 years ago, a group of companies, human rights and press freedom organizations, investors and academics came together to form the Global Network Initiative, or GNI. GNI is the only multi-stakeholder initiative dedicated to freedom of expression and privacy in the ICT sector. Our members' collaboration is rooted in a shared commitment to the GNI principles, an evolving framework for responsible ICT company decision-making grounded in international human rights law. Member companies must demonstrate their commitment to this framework through an independent assessment of their policies and practices. Since GNI launched in 2008, membership has grown to include nearly 60 organizations and experts, including some of the world's largest ICT companies, affecting billions of users, as well as prominent civil society organizations from Africa, Asia, Europe, Latin America, and the Middle East. GNI offers a safe space to have challenging conversations and reach consensus, enabling engagement with high-level government officials and international organizations. And as more governments resort to ordering the shutdown of networks and services, from SMS to social media, our research and advocacy have raised awareness on the impacts of these tactics on the press, human rights activists, civil society, the economy, access to basic public services, and on the livelihoods of women, refugees, children, and other vulnerable groups. Our work has achieved results. Following a 15-month dialogue among experts, GNI members, and decision makers worldwide, our recommendations for rights-respecting ways to tackle online extremism were cited by the United Nations Counterterrorism Committee. Former United States Ambassador Samantha Power called on technology companies to join GNI and demonstrate their commitment to internet freedom. And sustainability indices, such as the London Stock Exchange, have included the GNI principles as a measure of commitment to human rights online. But there's more work to be done to promote the GNI principles as a standard for the ICT sector, to bridge the gaps between users, providers, and authorities, and to prove that failing to protect freedom of expression and privacy rights jeopardizes all human rights.